somebody told me the score while I was seeing flops at MGM National Harbor, and the Wizards
were getting punked.
They were getting smoked.
Right.
And then 20 minutes later, same guy goes, Wizards win by one. How did that happen?
What was the largest deficit they faced? When I saw it was about 18.
19, yeah.
Was it 19?
I think it was close to 20. Yeah.
I heard Bradley Beal after the game say something that I like to hear, and I put it up on our Facebook page, facebook.com/thejunks. Bradley Beal said, we're going to the playoffs. Mm. You believe him. Back.
Yeah, I think they can make up the two and a half. Depends if they make
the teams in front of them. Like a team like the Nets, I don't feel like they're going to drop out.
The Nets are pretty good.
And they're a solid team.
Yeah. Maybe the Magic drop out.
That was under the context of Leonsis saying publicly, I don't know if you told somebody that they're tank.
Right.
You know, they still have goals. They're not going to give up on the season. Not going to let the guys off the hook.
Right. They're just going to be mediocre organically.
Yeah.
I mean, all of these teams.
They don't have to tank.
These teams, and they're all just mediocre teams. Right. Charlotte, Detroit, Orlando, all up front of them. So, I think Eric's right. It depends on who they pick up at the deadline. And
well, also, if they don't give up any key guys.
Yeah, exactly.
And I think it depends if the other teams trade away. Like Orlando's, arguably their best player is their center, Vukovic. And he's always in trade rumors.
Look, the fact of the matter is...
They probably feel the same way the Wiz do. They can make a run for that 8 spot.
Fact of the matter is the Wizards can play better, even without John Wall. You just look at their home record versus their away record. They just got to clean up their road deal.
You know? 5-18
And
on
that counts. That's a good start. That was a home win.
That's even a good start.
Logden.
Definitely on the road. Definitely wasn't a home game.
Well, it's technically a home game.
I don't care what they classified it
right,
as.
Because they get to pick their jersey. Yeah, that's why it's a home game.
Technically, it's a home game.
There was nothing home about
it. Even though they played at the O2 Arena.
Yeah. Yeah, that was a good result for them. I know when I looked in early, so when I saw they were down 18-19, I immediately went to the box score, and they were their starters were struggling.
Yeah,
they were struggling to get anything going. Right, but Otto had a good game off the bench for him. It looked like
Beal ends up.
Beal
big
took a
numbers.
Ton of shots.
He was 10 for 29.
Yeah, he's taking.
He started very slowly.
But you know you have to beat the Knicks.
I like Bryant. Yeah.
The Knicks are what are the Knicks 10 or 11?
Yeah.
They're 10-34 now.
10-34.
Yeah. I like Bryant. I like Decker. I don't know.
I like me some Bryant. Yeah. Kind of have a little thing for him.
A nice little project for them.
Yeah.
And by the way, that goaltending call was a good call last night.
Yeah, it was in the cylinder for sure, and I think it was probably coming down, too.
It looked like it was coming down.
Yeah.
If Dwight Howard comes back, can't play him over Bryant.
No, you don't want to stifle the young man's development.
Well, is there any talk that he's close or anything?
It doesn't sound like he's close at all.
No, but at some point I would imagine that he gets healthy.
Yeah, I don't know. I just wrote him off.
You know what he's become? An old, broken-down rotational player at this point. He can't stay on the court.
Although last year he was really good.
Okay,
That's why the Wizards picked him up.
This year he's not.
Yeah.
This year he's got gluteal soreness or his butt hurts, whatever it is.
Well, he had surgery.
And he can't get on. He can't get on the court.
Well, he had surgery, so that's what's keeping him off now.
And I feel like Keith might mess things up.
Yeah.
They seem to be playing better, even though it's just 500. But I guess that's better.
All right.
But,
hey, well, they're 6-4 now.
But
without
make
John.
That charge to the 8 seed and get the.
This is what I like to do. We all like to do this. Look at the upcoming schedule.
All right.
Let's look at the upcoming schedule.
Yeah, I can never predict.
We're going to forecast dubs and losses here.
I understand that. But, you know, if they're playing, the Raptors or something, or the Bucks, you know, let's just see.
They have some softies. They have some cupcakes upcoming.
Let's see who they're playing in their next five.
All right.
Detroit at home.
Should win that.
You got to win it because you're chasing them, right?
Drummond will have 25 rebounds against them.
Those teams are even.
Now, correct. Next Thursday, Golden State comes to town.
Well, that's a big fat L.
Then they go to Orlando. All right, another team that they're chasing.
Well, they have three games
probably
on the road.
Probably a loss.
But again, they're terrible on the road, EB.
Yeah, and
by the way,
and then they play the Spurs. Spurs are really good. And then at Cleveland. All right, so three of their next five, really winnable. I mean, they're going to, but really.
And I probably can't watch the Wiz-Warriors game because it'll just enrage me to see every bandwagon Warriors fan sitting in the stands.
I don't think they'll go 3-2, though, because two of those are on the road.
Probably not. I'm just saying, three of them are winnable.
Which I don't like to give that much credence to it, but this team clearly struggles on the road.
Probably depends on what teams have back-to-backs and different factors.
True. Look, they're going to win some of those games we don't expect. They're going to lose some of them we don't expect, but... I'm just saying that they've got some winnable matchups coming up.